things around here. They're the talk of the neighborhood.
Voila! My yellow roses, my... my daughter. Darling, turn that down, please. I can offer you a comfortable home, a sunny garden, a congenial atmosphere, my cherry pies.
Very persuasive salesman, Mrs.
Thank Haze. You. What was the decisive factor? My garden?
I think it was your cherry pies.
Oh. Those wrong corners. You're going to take my queen?
That was my intention, certainly.
Betty, bye, dear.
Good night. Good night.
Good night, Lyon.
This is Mr. Humbert. Kenny Overton.
How do you do?
You having a good time?
Mm-hmm.
Well, we'll see you then.
Mm-hmm.
Bye-bye.
You see, I'm a strongly emotional woman. Very strongly emotional. Oh, don't be afraid of hurting me.
No, I'm not, really.
Take me in your arms. Oh, I can't live in the past. Not anymore, Hum. Not anymore.
Hi.
Please,
darling.
Cha-cha-cha.
Darling, did you come back for something?
No, Mona's party turned out to be sort of a drag.
Excuse me. It's loaded with mayonnaise just the way you like it.
Thank you.
Darling, take it upstairs.
I don't want to go to bed. It's too early.
We all think that Lo should go to bed.
I don't have to. This is a free country.
Which means there will be no allowance this week.
Which means I think you stink this week.
To bed this instant! I heard that. Must you pamper your pimples?
Do you mind if I eat? I've got to meet Mona.
Oh, this morning you have to meet Mona. Last night... Look, first you wash every dish, then you go upstairs and you make your bed and you clean up your room. I am not picking up after you today, miss! Or any day!
Well, I'm very glad you called me, Jean. Well, there's something very important we both have to talk about.
Here's your breakfast.
Thank you very much. Good morning.
Good morning. Don't tell Mom, but I ate all your bacon.
You have a very long face today.
Oh, yeah?
Huh? Annoyed when you left her party last night?
Mona? Annoyed?
Well, I thought she might be looking forward to...
Don't worry about Mona.
This it?
You mean,
Yeah.
Find a cot for us. I asked them downstairs in the lobby to find a cot.
A cot?
Yes.
You're crazy.
Why, my darling?
Because, my darling, when my darling mother finds out, she's going to divorce you and strangle me.
Wake up, Humbert. The hotel's on fire. The hotel's on fire. Quick.
What? They're on fire?
Yeah, but... get out of bed real quick. Quick, it's burning right down to the ground.
Why can't I call my mother if I want to?
Because you can't.
Why?
Because your mother is dead.
Come on now, cut it out. Why can't I call her?
Your mother is dead. I was driving around and I thought I saw you through the window.
Oh, yeah, well, we stopped there for a malt afterwards. What difference does it make?
You were sitting at a table with two boys.
Yeah, well, Roy and Rex just happened to sit down with us.
Roy and Rex?
The co-captains of the football team.
I thought we understood no dates.
What do you mean, no dates? They just sat down at our table.
I don't want you around them. They're nasty-minded boys.
Oh, you're a fine one to talk about someone else's mind.
You see before you a weary goat. The bewitcher is bewitched.
Look, Semiramis, look.
Yes, the goat removeth his horns.
Let us take him to the dark kingdom.
Yes,
to the dark kingdom. Away, away.
Look, the play has two more performances next week.
Oh, don't start talking about the play to me. That's what's just come between us. That's what started this whole row. Look, don't you want to get back to where we were before we came to this horrible place? Don't you want to come away with me?
No! I hate you! I hate you!
Lolita, you you're going to stay with this filthy boy. That's what it's...
Yes! Why did you leave
Shut
me
your
alone?
Mouth, you heartless little...
Don't tell me what
psychopath.
You do! You're
I promise you one thing.
Grand.
You're not going to see these filthy boys anymore, I tell you that. That's one
oh,
thing...
Oh, yeah? Well, I've got news for you. I'm going to do anything I want to, anytime
shut
I
up,
want to, with anybody I want
mouth.
To. And you can't stop
shut
me.
Up. When did the doctor say that you can leave the hospital?
What?
Are you going to read the magazine or talk to me for a while?
Sure.
When did the doctor say that you can leave the hospital?
I think he wants me to stay another 48 hours.
Yeah, that's all right. We can start early on Tuesday morning and we'll make the Mexican border in 3 days. And it'll be the end of all those mysterious agents following us around.
Mr. Humbert, I must ask you to move your car.
I am just leaving.
Goodbye. Might catch your cold.
I shall stay in tonight and nurse my cold, so I shan't see you until tomorrow morning.